我们敬礼。
Let's pay homage to the lineage gurus.
敬礼了明。
Homage to the venerable monk 了明。
敬礼沙迦。
Homage to Master Sakya Zhenkong.
敬礼十六世。
Homage to His Holiness the 16th Karmapa.
敬礼。
And homage to Master Dubden Dharji.
我们敬礼坛城三宝。
Homage to the three jewels of the altar.
敬礼今天护摩的祖尊。
Homage to the main deity of Homa today.
Bilinga.
Bilinga.
童子天。
Bingala or Priyankara.
满愿童子。
The wish fulfilling youth of the youth heaven.
丹增嘎措
图登西地，丹增嘎措图登西地。
各位上师、教授师、
Dharma masters、Dharma educators、Dharma teachers、
讲师、助教、堂主、
Dharma instructors、Dharma tutors、directors of temples and chapters、and all disciples present here and over the internet。
大家午安，大家好。
Good afternoon. How do you do?
你好，大家好。新早感恩。I still.
I still.
谢浪的。
谢
浪的。Hola amigo.
Hola amigo.
Que quiero mucho.
Que quiero mucho.
Soy.
Soy.
一起吧。
一起吧。
気持ち。
気持ち。
準備。
準備。
ヤピ。
ヤピ。
プリンプリン。こんにちは。Now, as the lady and the gentleman. Next week, July 9, afternoon 3 o'clock p.m. is the Mahapala fire offering ceremony. Next week is大力金刚的父母。
Next Sunday, there would be Mahabala fire offering ceremony.
他的手印呢，就七颗印。
And his mudra is the wrathful mudra or Tarjani.
啊，就是这一尊呢。
That's this deity here.
这一尊的父母，刚刚大家看到这个。
Just now.
啊。那个影片也是大家是做大力金刚的父母。
Video where you all
这一尊是
Mahabala
Homa School 的大护法。
So this is the great protector of Tubuda School.
啊，今天呢是做这个满愿童子。
So today we perform the wish fulfilling youth, and as soon as you hear about wish fulfilling, immediately you registered for primary supplicants. So just now, when I was blessing the registration forms, I barely could lift it up.
Bilinga is.
Bingala or Priyankara
主要是哈利蒂姆的这个第五百子，第五百子
the 500th child of Mother Hariti。
那这个他的本身啊的因缘，是因为释迦牟尼佛
causes and conditions
把他收来，放在那个钵里面。
because Sakyamuni Buddha captured him inside his arms ball.
然后他得到
So, and he received the blessings of from Sakyamuni Buddha through the arms ball and gained the three insights and six transcendent powers.
It
sounds simple. There's benefit being captured by Sakyamuni Buddha. As long as you're captured, you will benefit. From it.
很容易他就得到三明六通.
So, and he gained the three insights and six powers very easily.
天灵灵,
the mantra that is chanted, may the heaven respond, may the earth respond.
和你地母,
Mother, may Mother Hariti command the wish fulfilling youth to descend.
这个咒是我们,
and
这个华语,
this mantra
华语的咒,
in Chinese.
一般来讲，梵文的咒是
and the Sanskrit
Bilinga Soha 就可以了。 Om Bilinga Soha 就是 Bilinga 也就是 Bingala
So Bingala
Bingala
Bilinga the same as
Bilinga
Bingala Bingala became Bilinga
藏日的念法 Bilinga
The Tibetan
冰觉啦,
Sanskrit, Pinjala, Tibetan, Bilinga. Actually, they refer to the same thing. That's calling on his name. And the Chinese mantra was created by myself.
We
When we were little, on the 15th of the 8th month, the full moon, the frog god, to invoke the frog god, may the heaven respond, may the earth respond. On the 15th of the 8th month, please come
and attach.
啊，细卡行，零零零，千里背尾走过来就行。这个就是小孩子，我们小孩子小的时候在玩。小朋友那个装成青蛙，趴在地上。另外的人拿着香在旁边念。 And then the others were holding incense and then chanting that mantra.
And then
the spirit, or the frog spirit, I suppose, came and attached to him and he started to hop around just like a frog. It's very easy to be a medium or to be attached by the spirit. Even the frog has a spirit. Actually, everything has spirit. They have that spirit body, the spirit energy. And I use may the heaven respond, may the earth respond, and may Mother Hariti command the wish fulfilling youth to descend and come. That's in Chinese. Mother Hariti is Pingala's mother. So when the mother calls on him, then he would definitely come. That's what I meant. So the wishful fulfilling youth has three insights and six powers. And he's also in heaven called the youth heaven. He helps being, he has three insights. And the three insights are the insights of the celestial eye that can see very far away. So they can see very far. And the second, the other one is the clarity or the insight of knowing all lifetimes, the past, present and future, which I often say, begin, began, that refers to the past, present, and future.
三世因果，他都知道。
To the cause and effects of the three lifetimes. That's the clarity of knowing all lifetimes. And the other one is the clarity to end all afflictions or exhaustive outflow. So he's inside the alms bowl, and all the essence or the nutrients taken by Sakyamuni Buddha was inside the alms bowl.
So,
because he's inside the alms bowl, that's the same that he's absorbing all the things that Shakyamuni Buddha has gotten. So that's why he had the clarity of exhaustive outflow, that the afflictions have been eliminated completely
and have been
sent. So, and he's from the youth heaven, which is rarely known to people. So he's able to help all sentient beings. So by calling upon him, the primary supplicants will have their wishes fulfilled. That's why he fulfilled the wishes of sentient beings. So today, when everybody heard about the wish-fulfilling youth, everybody registered for the primary supplicants. And that's a wonderful thing. Last time, we also talk about
the
separation between the lotus leaf and lotus blossom. So lotus leaf youth and lotus youth are together. So the original ground too is the same, which is Amitabha Buddha.
Amitabha Buddha
was the origin. So in today's Buddhism, Amitabha Buddha is the greatest reliance. Most Sutric Buddhist practitioners would chant Namo Amitabha. In Tantric Buddhism, in the past, someone asked Master Norna Rinpoche of Nyingma, what is the greatest Dharma practice? What is the greatest Dharma? And he replied, it's the great Dharma of Amitabha. That's the greatest Dharma. Because when Amitabha is delivering sentient beings, it's infinite, boundless. So the great Dharma of Amitabha is the greatest, according to Norda
Rinpoche.
And also in Tantric Buddhism, like Grandmaster now, the practice that Grandmaster does daily is also Amitabha Buddha. When performing the 1,000 Dharma vessels Bardo deliverance, the primary Pure Land is Amitabha Sukhavati. So that's the same as the great Dharma of Amitabha. So for Bardo deliverance, we also use Amitabha, because Amitabha Buddha's Pure Land, Sukhavati, is the Pure Land that's praised by all the Buddhas of the Ten Directions. Of course, that's the best.
So
So generally speaking, in the future, like the Pure Land of Padmakumara or the Lotus Youth is the Maha Twin Lotus Ponds, and that's inside Amitabha Buddha's Pure Land.
So Chubura
School, the sentient beings delivered by Chubura School is also the most. the most numerous.
这个非常的灵感,
very responsive.
这有灵有现的,
it's very responsive. Spiritual responses or yogic responses. Did you see anything when we did the Bengala Homa earlier?
Among all of you here,
did you see any transformation in the sky earlier?
你们如果有看见的, 不妨你们现在可以,
if you saw something, please raise your hand.
讲说你有看到,
and say what you saw. Master Lian Chi. Okay, please be seated. Anybody else?
还有看到了举手啊, 勇敢一点,
please be brave and raise your hand.
你就躺在床上, 敲你的枕头, otherwise, 非常后悔,
you would go home and regret it so much that you punch your pillows. Someone raised their hand. I saw Manohara first, and I saw little kids flying in the sky. Anybody else? So, Pingala filling the whole sky, the same as what Master Lian Chi said.
还有没有? 勇敢一点啊,
anybody else? Please be brave. You would regret when you go home
没有讲,
that you didn't say anything.
Oh, 是李琦吗?
Is that Li Qi? I saw many Pingala here playing with balloons.
Oh,
that's why the balloons pop. Thank you very much.
他看到是埋怨童子是师尊。
So he saw that Grandmaster is the wistful feeling youth.
其实还有谁?
我。
Anybody else?
是的，我刚刚看到就是那个埋怨童子特别纯真的样子，然后显现在天空中，然后当时就觉得非常惭愧，因为他的眼中闪烁的光芒是那种纯洁无瑕的，就是当时我眼泪就流下来，就觉得，对，就是希望像他一样那么纯洁的无瑕。
I wish to be just like him, as innocent and pure.
所以大家都讲得很对,
what everybody said was right. But we only have one thing here.
所以这一样东西啊,
Because everybody said the right things.
Then
we'll just give you candies later. Actually, all the same, one important thing of the three insights or three clarities is the clarity to end all afflictions completely. What does it mean? There's nothing to worry, nothing to concern. So there are, he has no concerns and no afflictions. In our spiritual cultivation, the most important thing, and it's also mentioned in Vimalakirti Sutra, is no concerns, no entanglements. You have no afflictions inside your heart at all. That's the complete outflow of all afflictions, then you're close to Tao.
Or
the way, if you still have afflictions, then you're still very far from Tao. If you still have even a slight attachment, then you're still far from Tao. It's mentioned in the Vimalakirti Sutra of the 10 great disciples of the Buddha. Although they have attainments of arhatship, which is one of the four Sichli realms,
arhats,
the highest of the Sravakahood, they still have afflictions. So that's why the clarity to end all afflictions completely is very crucial.
The
exhaustive outflow or complete outflow is not the complete outflow of mundane beings. That's a term in Buddhism. When a man has a complete outflow, then they would be pale and scrawny and about to die. But this term, exhaustive outflow or complete outflow, means that all afflictions are completely outflowed. Which means you have no entanglements, no concerns whatsoever. That's why Vimalakirti asked me, can you put down everything? I said, yes.
It's easy.
Why don't you just walk into this great mirror-like light? Then you would go back to your original. You know, why you want to stay here? Sometimes hot, sometimes cold. Sometimes I have swollen feet, and sometimes I have to go to the bathroom. And you're scared of this, scared of that. Why don't you just enter into this light of the
mirror?
The pure light, the great
pure light. I did
not walk into this great, bright, pure light. Is that if she doesn't see me around anymore, that would not be good. Although I have no use to her,
这个总是有一个人可以看到啊,
but at least he can see me.
就是这种想法而已,
that's what I thought.
所以还是留下来,
so that's why I stayed. I did not go into the circle of bright pure light.
我告诉你我那时候的死法是什么样子的死法, 我,
you know what kind of death that would be? Let me tell you frankly.
就是血糖到了最低,
the blood sugar dropped to the lowest,
全身虚脱, 昏迷,
the whole body is collapse and then enter into a
昏迷,
coma and then gone.
脑部缺氧,
so when the blood sugar dropped, and then you enter into a coma and you lack oxygen in the brain, then you die, and then you leave the world. That's a very fast way to die. Less than one day, just in a few hours. That's the best kind of death. There are only two kinds of deaths that's fast. That's fastest. One is through brain or heart, and the rest are not that fast.
将来走的时候啊, 最好是真的,
in the future, when I pass,
或者心脏, 两样东西,
it's best if it just starts from the brain or heart, then you can leave the world very fast, the best way.
第一等, 那是属于第一等死亡,
that's the
那一天我,
first rate of death.
就是第一等,
if I had gone that day, that would be the first rate of death.
诶,
I'm lying in bed, and then the second day, I'm gone.
所以没有走, 诶,
but I did not go.
留下也好啦,
it's also good to just stay around. This is called just going according to just following the sentient beings, which is, and Vimalakirti Sutra also talks about just following, and following, quote-unquote, following is the same as equality. There is nothing special about Grandmaster Lu. I don't know anything. If you ask me to pay or to file tax return, I don't know how. You ask me to play the smartphones, I don't know how.
But
kids nowadays, they all know how to play with the phones. But I don't know. But I do have a cell phone.
It's
Dharma Sister Hanifa gave it to me. I know how to drive the Rolls Royce, but I don't understand all the charts. That's all I know. But if it breaks, I don't know how to take care of it. So I am a retarded person for mundane life. So I just know how to turn on the phone and then make a phone call and then
just
hang up and turn off the phone, that's all.
其他呢,你叫我说上网,
if you ask me to get on the internet, I cannot. Or you want me,
if you,
I don't know how to check voicemails, text, camera, nothing. I've never done any of that. And I don't know how to send or read text either. I just know how to make a phone call. really so down. I don't know how to file tax return or to check the accounts or how many zeros are in the account or I don't know how to use money. It's really bad. I've never spent any money. I haven't gone to Safeway or Fred Meyer.
YG Maya也没有去过。哪里都没有去过,
I haven't been anywhere. Where have I been? Just the Leizang temples.
回到哪里?
Where did you go?
还要去哪里?
Home. Where else?
没有了。
No other places. Well, there's one more. One thing I can do is to write. To write the articles, to write books.
大家学会了满愿童子法,
once you master, learn and master the Pingala Dharma practice,
你什么都行,
and if you attain fusion, then you can do everything. For myself, my physical body cannot do anything, but my Dharma bodies can do everything.
在泰国清迈,
in Chiang Mai, in Thailand,
住在泰国清迈,
the one living in Chiang Mai, Lianhua Mulan,
男的, 是男的,
a man,
是自然的男, 啊, 不是花木兰的兰, 木, 是莲花木兰, 现在在泰国清迈,
莲花木兰, 啊, in Chiang Mai, Thailand,
我的法身,
had seen my Dharma body, and here someone also had seen my Dharma body. No need to say the girl, the woman, but the man. Gao Sishiong.
Gao Sishiong.
Dharma brother Gao.
He
had seen my Dharma body too.
你看这里呢, 有男的看过我的法身的吗?
Anybody else? Any other men who had seen my Dharma body? I should not call on the women because they all would stand up.
看过华生呢, 看过, 确实看到, 不是做梦哦, 做梦的不算啊,
it's not in the dreams, okay? The dreams are not counted.
而且华生会讲话,
and the Dharma body can speak in many different languages. He can speak in different languages. Many different languages. And countless emanations of the Dharma bodies. So once you attain fruition in the wishful feeling youth Dharma practice, in the future you can also emanate countless bodies. In addition, all your wishes can be fulfilled. It's the same for me now. I cannot think of things in your heart because it will happen. Whatever you think about, whatever you think about, it happens. You think about the diamond comes. You think of a car, the car came. Whatever you think of, it comes. 80 years old now. And I still wrote two books about love letters.
80歲呢。
And the girls are in their 20s.
真的。所以不能亂想。
So we shouldn't have any thoughts.
念头不可以乱想,
that's why I say, don't casually think of things. Because the Siddhikarpa Sutra said, all sentient beings in the world, their thoughts and actions, any one thought, any one action, are all karma.
所以我们《真佛经》里面有提到,
That's why in the Two Buddha Sutra it's mentioned that the state of no mind is the true Buddha jewel.
Huh?
What? We have Q&A today? I thought we don't. That's why I spoke so much.
Huh?
That's for next week. Then why did you put it here this week? This is for next week. So is it this week or next week? And we still have cake cutting after this.
Ming
texts his boss, can I take a day off tomorrow? Please approve.
老板回答,
the boss replies, sure.
这个老板又给他简讯了,你该不会是要去面试新的工作吧?
You're interviewing for a new job somewhere?
小明回答,
and Ming
replied,
no, impossible. I'm very loyal
老板,
to you.
你说这种话,
how could you say that? I feel really sad that you said that.
这个老板跟他讲,
and the boss continued.
简讯给他, 问题是,
the problem is,
复利表,
you sent your resume to my company, my other company.
This joke. This world's funniest person was a driver's teacher.
The most humorous person in the world happens to be a driving school instructor.
教练,
and Ming said to the instructor, I'm so nervous.
教练回答,
and the instructor, what are you nervous about? The ones who should be nervous are the pedestrians.
教练讲, 红灯,
and the instructor said,
你也不过去, 绿灯,
you don't go at
你也不过去,
red light, and you also don't go at green light.
是不是没有你喜欢的颜色?
Is that because you don't like those colors?
教练问小明,
and the instructor asked
你看到那个人了吗?
Did you see that person?
小明说看到了,
and he said
教练讲,
yes. And the, driver, the instructor said, hit him and kill him. And Ming said,
教练讲说,
oh, I don't dare. Then why didn't you put on the brake then?
笑话, huh? 这个必须要懂得国语的,
this is only meaningful in Chinese.
会笑, 在, 到了饭馆吃饭的时候, 有一个阿伯, 就走过来问, 醋你要不要?
This is, it's only in Chinese.
虾米, 阿伯, 你也帮帮忙, 拉客怎么拉到餐厅来<笑>过来一会儿阿伯又不死心了又过来问一次醋你要不要<笑>真是火大了我大声回答不要了阿伯这时候才伸手拿着我桌子上的醋<笑> 刚刚啊，朋友在问我，
just now a friend asked me，
存人生的第一桶金需要多久时间？
How long will it take to save a bucket of gold？ I don't even have the bucket. How can I have the money？
好，我们讲维摩诘经哈。
Now we will expound on the Vimalakirti Sutra.
知诸法如幻相，
know that all
无他性
Dharma.
这个跟大家讲清楚，这一句话很重要。
Illusory with neither self nature nor other nature. Please pay attention.
这个娑婆世界的一切，人间呐，
everything in this world
都是幻化出来。
The human world is all illusory.
都是幻化出来的。
It comes from illusion.
没有所谓的我。
They have no self nature.
没有所谓的他。
And no other nature. The so-called self and the so-called others do not exist.
这个大企业讲。
Vimalakirti told Mahakashyapa.
思想错误。
You have the wrong thought.
你要搞清楚啊！
You need to be clear.
你以为你是福田僧？
You think that you are a monk with great blessing.
你给他加持就是赐福给他。
So by giving others blessing,
让他由这个穷变成富。
You can transform the poor into the rich.
就是给他赐福。
By begging for alms from them, you're bestowing blessings to them.
你就是福田僧。
By having the thought that you're a monk with great blessings,
有福分的人
才出家。A monk with the feel of blessings,
没有福分的，他不会出家。
That's a term for the monk, as if that you only become ordained because you have blessings. But such a thought is also wrong.
所谓福。
The so-called blessings
是幻的
are illusory.
你以为你自己有福，心中啊，我是福田僧。
That you are blessed.
你有这种想法，你就错了。
By having such a thought,
you are wrong.
So Mahakashyapa was really wrong. How can you give blessings to others? Because that's illusory to begin with.
哪里有我？
How could they be self?
哪里有什么福呢？
And because there's no self, how can they be blessings?
也是一个幻。
And the recipients also illusory.
他也是幻人。
You are an illusory person, and the others are also illusory people.
你拿什么福去赐给人家？
So what kind of blessings can you bestow upon others?
无他性，就是没有对方，
no other nature,
没有你自己，
which means others do not exist and you yourself also do not exist.
你真正懂得法了，知道没有自己也没有他。
If you truly comprehend Dharma, you would know there is no self and there is no others.
也没有
是福之物。So what can you bestow?
一切都是自然的。
So there is nothing to bestow. Everything is natural, intrinsic.
所以说要知道啊，诸法如幻相。
So you need to know that all dharma, meaning everything, is illusory.
你说
the saha world is illusory.
这个有分别心，这富的我不去。
You have differentiating mind. Oh, I don't want to beg from the rich.
啊，穷的人家去托钵。
I will just go for alms from the poor.
这个就是你自己本身的没有随顺缘分。
So that means you don't follow your affinity. You don't know how to do that.
不懂得随顺缘分。
Which is just following the affinity, which we just talked about earlier. That's very important.
碰到富的，有钱的，我就去托钵。
When you go for alms.And you don't want to get anything from the rich, you just want it from the poor. That's the discriminating mind.
So that means
that you have certain consciousness or sense that this person is rich and that person is poor. Actually, they're all equal. So no self nature, no other nature. They were originally that way. So Buddha nature was unborn, non-arising, and non-ceasing.
They
are natural. The blessings too are natural.
So
you think that you're blessed and you're bestowing upon sentient beings. If you have such a thought, you're wrong. You cannot have such a thought. If you like to give, that's good, but you should not be mindful of the giving. You should not think about the giving. Everything is just done naturally. So it's non-arising and non-ceasing. Kashyapa, if without relinquishing the eight wrongs, what are the eight wrongs? Are the opposite of the eightfold noble path. On the Noble Eightfold Path, the opposites are called the Eight Wrongs. So, in the Saha world, it's very rare to have the Eightfold Noble Path. Most are just about the Eight Wrongs, but through the eight wrongs, you can enter the eight liberations. How can you enter the eight liberation without relinquishing the eight wrongs? This is very difficult to explain. Sentient beings are lustful, angry, and ignorant. Because all sentient beings are lustful, because without lust, there will not be any sentient beings. So you can follow your lusts, but still have attainments in your spiritual cultivation. That's why the Vimalakirti Sutra mentioned that lust, anger, and ignorance are also Buddha Dharma. So you can cultivate spiritually following your lust and also following your anger and hatred, or following your delusion and ignorance. You can still cultivate spiritually, and you can attain Buddhahood by following your lust or greed, and you can become Herukas by following your anger, and you can become Bodhisattvas by following your ignorance or delusion. You need to be able to understand this. If you don't, that's all. God. The second vehicle, or small vehicle, that's what Kashyapa was. So you cannot touch lust, you cannot touch anger, you cannot touch ignorance, you cannot touch everything. You can only be alone.
So,
I will explain this in the future. This is very difficult to explain. Holding on to the wrong phenomena, you can enter right Dharma. Everything is Buddha Dharma. There is nothing that is not Buddha Dharma. So, through the wrong phenomena, enter the right Dharma. when I just follow the path, people criticize me that I was the deviant heretic. Now it's clear to me. So I am a deviant that's borrowing on the Buddha, kind of. So you call yourself a Buddhism, but actually you're a heretic on the deviant path. And now I would just say it straight to you. Go your head. I am a Buddha myself. Why do I have to rely on anything? I'm not saying I'm a Buddha. I am a Buddha. But you are also a Buddha. And they are also a Buddha. Everybody is a Buddha. Why do we need to rely? Only those who don't get it don't understand that we have to rely on a Buddha. Because I'm a Buddha already, why do I need to rely on a Buddha? There's no need. What is the deviant path? All the paths in the world
are
all kinds. You yourself are a path. There is no deviant or right, deviant or outside path, inside path, or in between. So all people, all spiritual cultivators who have attained the path of Tao came from outside to the inside. Well, but there's no such thing either. Actually, naturally, they're all just Tao, or the path. What kind of criticism was that? Because they did not understand. But once you are enlightened, you would know that you can enter right Dharma through wrong phenomena. Is there anybody that doesn't enter the right Dharma through wrong phenomena? Is there anyone that's originally already right Dharma? The right Dharma has been in you all along, but you just do not realize or recognize it. And one time, one day, when you recognize it, then, oh, it turns out that I am the right Dharma. I am a Buddha. And everybody is a Buddha. But because you have not reached such a realm, then you are the wrong phenomena. But in the future, you would also know that wrong phenomena is also right Dharma. That's why the Vimalakirti Sutta said that afflictions are enlightenment of body. The Buddha and Mara are the same. Yes, the name of temple in LA. So Mara is also a Buddha. Ultimately, let me tell you something. That hells are also the pure land of pure and serene light, which is the highest pure land of Sukhavati. I really don't understand why hells are the pure land of pure serene light. Once you attain Tao, there is no suffering, no happiness. Once you truly attain Tao, there are only four words: permanence, blissful, true self, and pure. Yeah, there's no suffering. Even hells are also blissful. I don't know. I can't even see it clearly. One meal, you feed all beings. Don't think that you're eating by yourself. Kashyapa, whatever you eat, actually, is not offered to you, but it's offered to all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. So by taking a lump of food, actually, it's the same as all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas taking the food. So one meal to feed all beings. Because whatever you take in your mouth is offering to all the ten Dharma realms. So you're not eating by yourself. It's not just you that's eating. So the offering practice that we do is whatever you take is offered to all the Buddhas and deities in the ten realms. So you only eat after offering to all the Buddhas and sages and beings. So the eater is either having afflictions or without afflictions. So you're not apart from the afflictions, but you're not afflicted. It's very difficult to explain. So you don't abandon afflictions, but you don't have afflictions. So that's why afflictions are bodhi, bodhi or enlightenment. Like I don't abandon the Saha world, but in reality I have abandoned the Saha world. As such, the one who eats neither have afflictions nor without afflictions. You know, I have reprimanded Sariputra, your fellow disciple. And now I also reprimand you, Mahakashyapa. Sariputra thought that now I'm in meditation, and then he exited meditation, then became mundane being. And he was a sage when he was a meditation. But I never think about entering or exiting meditation. I'm always in meditation. Only that would be correct. So I do not think about afflictions, but I don't abandon afflictions, but I truly have no afflictions. In such a case, afflictions are bodhi or enlightenment. I don't think about entering meditation or exiting meditation, but I am always in meditation. Only then is it true meditation. That's what Vimalakirti told Mahakashyapa. What is meditation? Let me know. Let me tell you. It's neither entering nor exiting meditative state. Only then is it true meditation. I don't abandon afflictions, but I have no afflictions. I'm not in samsara, but I'm also not in nirvana. Vimalakirti said, neither stay in samsara nor in nirvana. Usually we say, if you enter nirvana, you abandon samsara, right? Or if you stay in samsara, then you're not in nirvana. But Vimalakirti said, that's wrong. Samsara is nirvana. Nirvana is samsara. And more profound is hells are the pure land of pure serene light. It's very shocking. One who gives alms in this manner has neither great blessing nor small blessings. You think that you bestow upon the poor people? What is big, what is small blessing? Once you discriminate between big and small, you are a mundane being. There's no differentiating between big and small, or blessings or not. Or neither benefiting or harming others. So I don't benefit others and they don't lose anything either. That's the intrinsic suchness of everything. You need to understand this. Only this is the path of Tao. Only this is Dharma. Doesn't matter what I explain if you don't say, don't understand. So this is a positive and negative side, the dualistic. This is the proper way to enter the Buddha's path without relying on Shravakahood. The true Buddha path is not arhatship, not Shravakahood. You're only practicing Shravakahood, that's a small vehicle. But I am the one who has entered the Buddha's path. Mahakasyapa, with this mind, you will not eat in vain the food that others have given you. By teaching you how to go for alms, then you will not eat other people's offering in vain. Now do you understand? Incredible. Vimalakirti was truly incredible. What he talked about here is a true Buddha Dharma. So, truthfully speaking, that he was teaching the 10 great disciples to move from the small to the less, from the lesser to the greater vehicle. So what is prohibited, what is not, those are all remedial practices. But now I'm teaching the greater vehicle. And Mahakasyapa said, World Honored One, when I heard the words of Vimalakirti, which I never heard of before, I could not say anything in return. I had no ability to debate with him. I lost to him. His eloquence and wisdom are unhindered. Vimalakirti was truly incredible. I don't dare to go see him. Mahakasyapa said, but let me tell you, if you have not reached that state, and if you cannot transform your greed, anger, and delusion into spiritual cultivation, then don't touch it casually. Only if you can transform your greed, anger, and delusion, then you can follow the wishes of the sentient beings and practice the Dharma of greed, anger, and delusion. So I like to warn you about this. Don't think that because Grandmaster said everything is fine, that then you just go and do it. Then it'll be impossible for you to attain Tao because you cannot transform. You're unable to transform. That's all for today.